I said goodnight. He was watching a movie with two of his friends, and he looked fine. He looked a little tired, but nothing out of the ordinary. And my husband and I went up to bed, and at 3 in the morning, found him on the couch, barely breathing.
At just 19 years old, Jared Barber's young life was cut short by a prescription drug overdose. And now his mother is speaking out in the hopes of helping others.
I'm not the only mother here. I'm speaking for all these other mothers out here that have lost their son to drugs the same way. And it's an epidemic out here.
An epidemic that, in the Barber's case, cost them their son.
I took my son to the doctor to get help. 3 short months later, he died.
For years, the Barber's son, Jared, struggled with anxiety. By his sophomore year in high school, he began taking marijuana and other drugs to help deal with that anxiety. Recognizing a problem, Jared's family stepped in and took him to a doctor they were referred to.
My son had a problem. He didn't want the doctor to know he had a drug problem to begin with. So I called the doctor before his first visit, and I told him my son had a drug problem, and I was afraid to put him on any prescription drugs. He was aware of that. So the last visit, I went to every visit with them for 2 months. The last visit, my son was very distraught because a close friend passed away of cancer. He made his own appointment and went into that visit on his own. He wanted me waiting outside, you know, and I thought he just wanted to talk about his friend who passed away. But he came out of that room with handfuls of Seroquel from the doctor, knowing that he had a drug problem. My son was complaining of lack of sleep. Well, of course, when a teenager is going to bed at 3 in the morning and then their friends are waking them up at 7 in the morning, they're not going to have enough sleep. Don't prescribe Seroquel, which is an antipsychotic medication, to a 19-year-old because he can't sleep. It wasn't even FDA approved.
And by speaking out, Jodi Barber is hoping that stricter regulations on prescription drugs will be passed and that more doctors will take steps to ensure that their patients aren't abusing prescription drugs. She's also written the state medical board to get her son's doctor's license revoked. For the Orange County Register, I'm Tanya Lyon.